Welcome back for a second example of solving a quadratic inequality. Here we want to solve 2x squared plus 3x minus 5
greater than 0.
The solution to this will be all the x values that satisfy this inequality. We'll first solve this by hand and then solve it graphically. To solve this by hand, the first step is to determine the x values for which 2x squared plus 3x minus 5 is equal to 0. And then we'll use those values to form intervals on the number line and then test each interval to see which satisfy this inequality. So again, the first step is to solve the equation 2x squared plus 3x minus 5 equals 0. This is factorable. The factors of 2x squared are 2x and x. Now we'll place the factors of negative 5 in the second positions so that the sum of the inner product and outer product is equal to positive 3x. So for the factors of negative 5, let's put a positive 5 here and a negative 1 here, or minus 1 here. Notice how the inner product is 5x, the outer product is negative 2x, which has a sum of positive 3x. So this is factored correctly. So the solutions occur when 2x plus 5 equals 0, or when x minus 1 equals 0. Well, here we would subtract 5 and divide by 2. X equals negative 5 halves. Here we have x equals 1. Now these are the values where 2x squared plus 3x minus 5 is equal to 0. So these are the two values of x where 2x squared plus 3x minus 5 is equal to 0. But notice when this is equal to 0, 0 is not greater than 0, so it does not satisfy this inequality. So what that means is, when we form our number line and plot these two values to form our intervals, we're going to make open points at these values to show these are not part of the solution. So let's go ahead and assume negative 5 halves is here. We'll make an open point here. And let's say positive 1 is here. We'll make an open point here as well. If the inequality symbol was greater than or equal to 0, then these points would actually be closed because these two values would be part of the solution. Notice by plotting these two points, we've now formed three intervals, one on the left, one in the middle, and one on the right. So now we'll pick a test value in each interval. If the test value satisfies the inequality, then the interval is part of the solution. If it doesn't, then the interval is not part of the solution. So now we'll pick a test value less than negative 5 halves, or negative 2.5. Let's test x equals negative 3. Let's test x equals 0 in the middle. And let's test x equals 2 on the right. And now we'll perform substitution into our inequality. So when x is negative 3, we would have 2 times negative 3 squared plus 3 times negative 3 minus 5. We want to know if this is greater than 0. Negative 3 squared is 9 times 2 is 18. Plus, this would be negative 9 minus 5. So 18 plus negative 9 is 9. 9 minus 5 is 4. 4 is greater than 0. So this is true. Therefore, the entire interval to the left of negative 5 halves is true, or part of the solution. So we'll go ahead and graph this interval, because it's part of our solution. Now we'll test x equals 0. Well, when x equals 0, we would just have 0 plus 0 minus 5, or negative 5 greater than 0. This is false. Negative 5 is not greater than 0, which means this interval here is false as well, or not part of the solution. And now we'll test x equals 2. So we'll have 2 times 2 squared plus 3 times 2 minus 5 greater than 0. 2 squared is 4 times 2 is 8. So we'd have 8 plus 6 minus 5 greater than 0.
So this will be 14 minus 5, which is equal to 9. 9 is greater than 0.
So the interval on the right is also true, or part of our solution. So this graph is the solution to our quadratic inequality, but let's also list it using interval notation and inequalities. So as we move right, we approach positive infinity. As we move left, we approach negative infinity. So using interval notation, it would be the interval from negative infinity to negative 5 halves. It's open on 5 halves, or the open interval from 1 to infinity. Using inequalities, we could say x is less than negative 5 halves, or x is greater than positive 1. Now let's go ahead and solve this graphically. To solve 2x squared plus 3x minus 5 greater than 0, we graph the function f of x equals 2x squared plus 3x minus 5. Or if we want, just y equals 2x squared plus 3x minus 5. So this inequality is going to be greater than 0 when the function is greater than 0. And when we talk about function values, we're talking about y values. So the y values will be greater than 0 when the function is above the x-axis. So notice how the y values are positive here on the right, because the function is above the x-axis, as well as on the left when the function is above the x-axis. But remember, we're looking for a solution in terms of x.
So on the right, the function is above the x-axis when x is greater than 1.
So on the x-axis, it would be the open interval from 1 to infinity. And on the left, it would be the open interval from negative 5 halves to negative infinity. Again, we don't include the x-intercepts here because we want to know when it's greater than 0, not greater than or equal to 0. So while it does take quite a bit of work to solve these by hand, solving them graphically is very straightforward as long as the x-intercepts of the function are real and rational. I hope you found this helpful.